Hey guys, welcome to a Year 12 Maths B tutorial. In order to understand anything about what I'm about to show you, you need to have done the Year 11 calculus tutorials. So make sure you have done that before continuing. Okay, so we're going to talk about anti-differentiation now. What is anti-differentiation? Well, if you remember how to differentiate, so if I give you a question like this, differentiate y equals 3x squared, and you differentiate it and you can get dy over dx equals 6x, this is called differentiation, right? We have a function which is y equals 3x squared, and we differentiate it to give us the gradient function, which is dy over dx equals 6x. Now, anti-differentiation refers to the opposite of differentiation. So I could give you the equation dy over dx equals 6x, and I ask you what y is, right? So that is the process of anti-differentiation. So how do you figure out, if I give you a differentiated equation, how do you go back and find out what y equals? Well, here is a general formula that can help you find it. So the formula is, if dy over dx is equal to a times x to the power of n, then y is equal to ax to the power of n plus 1 over n plus 1 plus c. Now, note that this only works for n does not equal negative 1. If n equals negative 1, then you need to use another method to anti-differentiate it. So let's try using this formula. So now we have dy over dx equals 6x. And we want to know what y is equal to. So applying the formula, a is equal to 6, and we have x, n is equal to 1, so it's 1 plus 1 over, n is 1, so it's 1 plus 1, and plus c, because we don't know what c is. So simplifying that, we have 6x to the power of 2 over 2 plus c. And simplifying again, we have y equals 6 divided by 2 is 3x squared plus c, which matches our differentiation equation that we've just done earlier. Y is equal to 3x squared. Dy over dx is equal to 6x. So this process of going from dy over dx to y, we call that solving a differential equation. In other words, anti-differentiate. Now let's talk about this symbol here, C. What is this symbol doing? Why do we need C? Because we know that 3x squared differentiates into 6x, so why do we need a constant C on the end? Well, that is because if y is equal to 3x squared plus any number here that is just a number on its own, so you're not allowed to attach an x to the number. So let's say I make up a number, let's say 7. This will also differentiate into 6x. So basically, c represents any constant that you can think of will be allowed in the y function that will still give you dy over dx is equal to 6x as the differentiated equation. So for example, if y is equal to 3x squared plus 15, y dash is still 6x. So that's why we put a symbol c there to represent that any constant at the back of the y equation will differentiate into this equation. Now, the last thing that I'll talk to you guys about is the symbol for anti-differentiation. So if you see this symbol, if you see that symbol there and you see 6x dx, this just means find the antiderivative of 6x. All right, so the answer is 3x squared plus c. All right, so 3x squared plus c is the antiderivative of 6x. Okay, so I've just written up some practice questions for you to have a go at. So try them out, come back when you're done. Okay, so let's have a look at how to do this. Well, following the formula, I should probably write down the formula first so you guys know how to use it. So I have dy over dx equals axn, and y is equal to ax n plus 1 over n plus 1 plus c. So therefore, applying that formula, I have y is equal to 4x. Now notice how I have x to the power of 1 here, so it's going to be 4x to the power of 2 over 2, and then minus 3, that can also be anti-differentiated. So I have minus 3. Now remember, x to the power of 0 is equal to 1. So I'm just going to add a little x to the power of 0 there. So if I anti-differentiate minus 3x to the power of 0, I get minus 3x to the power of 1 over 1. Because n here is equal to 0. 0 plus 1 is 1. So therefore, I also need to add another plus c in the end. So the answer is y equals 2x squared minus 3x plus c. So that's the antiderivative of dy over dx equals 4x minus 3. Now, if you want to test whether you're correct, you can simply differentiate this function again. So dy over dx, so this is a little test. Dy over dx is equal to 4x minus 3. So it matches what we had before. Okay, let's try this one. So y is equal to 3 over 4x to the power of 2 over 2 plus c. So you might think, hang on, this is a bit confusing. What do I do with this fraction within a fraction? Well, divided by 2, if you remember, just means times by a half, right, plus c. Now, so what that means is you can just put 3x squared at the top because it's 3 over 4 times x squared. So times x squared goes to the top, and on the bottom you have 4 times 2, which is 8. So I have plus c again. Right, now if you want to test whether you have this correct, you can differentiate it again. So dy over dx equals 2 times 3 over 8, so that's 6 over 8 x. And 6 over 8 can be simplified into 3 over 4 x. So that is definitely the answer. So tick your answer if you have it correct. And the third one, find the antiderivative of 4x squared plus 3x. So same thing, 4x cubed over 3 plus 3x squared over 2 plus c. And that's it. Okay, thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.